Pond candy, I love pond candy and licorice whips and nachos.
Nachos? When I was a kid, it was plain old American hot dogs. None of this nacho stuff.
Programs! Programs!
Programs? I want a program. You're going to teach me how to kick box score, Mom. Remember? So teach me today. Remember?
Yes, sir. Baseball like it should be. That's what they play here.
So I said to the salesman, I said, I'm not working today. And he said, why? He said, I'm going to the ball game, I said. And he said, what game? Can you imagine that? Can you imagine not knowing what game? The ball game, I said, I'm not going today.
How many stitches in a baseball?
108. Who won the 1926 World Series?
St. Louis. How many bases did Ty Cobb steal?
982. Who threw the first curveball?
Candy Cummings of the Brooklyn Excelsiors in 1867. In the 1934 All-Star game with five players who Carl Hubel strike out.
Joe Cronin, Al Simmons, Jimmy Fox, Babe Ruth, and Lou Gehrig.
What an intellect!
You too, buddy.
Babe Ruth, and that was a player. There'd never be another player like Babe Ruth. None of these guys will ever be like Babe Ruth.
Babe Ruth, Babe Ruth, Babe Ruth! All I ever hear about is Babe Ruth! What about Joe DiMaggio, huh? What about him? What about DiMaggio?
What about Mickey Mantle? Or Willie Mays? What about Willie Mays?
What about Hank Aaron? Hammer and Hank?
What about Cal Ripken? Or Barry Bonds? Or
what about the guys that aren't even playing yet?
And the girls. I bet the girls will be playing big leagues pretty soon.
I bet our guys are even going to do it this year.
Baseball. Definitely a game for dreamers.
A little hitting and a little feeling, and they're right back in it.
And diehards.
Right back in it? They've never been out of it.
See what I mean?
Are you kidding? You guys could win if Babe Ruth is playing for them.
Babe Ruth, Babe Ruth. All I ever hear is Babe Ruth.
You guys are losers.
Take that back. Hey, you bet they're going to win the division this year?
Yeah, I bet our guys are going to win the division this year.
And the pennant.
You tell her, Dad.
If you ever call my team losers again, I'll flush your autographed pictures of Babe Ruth down the toilet. Let's
sim down, man. A little pitching right back in it.
And some hitting.
And some feeling.
Wolves and Mavericks. Contrary to what you might have heard, an umpire's got to call them all straight down the middle. I'm never on one side, never on the other. Guess you could say I'm on the side of baseball.
Looking good, Wolves, looking good.
Hey, Kelly, throw the heater today.
Get a home run.
Hey, Nussbaum, looking good, looking good.
Woo! Yeah!
Play like Babe Ruth.
Babe Ruth, Babe Ruth, I'm sick of hearing about Babe Ruth.
Play like the Bambino.
And now, the Wolves have been gone Wolves starting lineup. Leading off and playing third base, Tracy Cameron. Batting second at second base, J.J. Rankin. Emerson Baxter gets the nod at left field and bats third. Playing right field and batting cleanup, Philo Baxter. Catching and batting fifth, Amy Baxter. Shortstop Cordy Baxter hits in the sixth spot. Andy Nussbaum playing first base, hits seventh. On the mound for the Wolves, batting eighth, Kelly Pulaski. And bringing up the rear in center field, Kenny Bowman.
Hope springs eternal. That's baseball.
That's indigestion.
the Mavericks.
I suppose you want to know how it's going to go for Kenny, right? Well, I'm not going to tell you, because that's another thing about baseball. It ain't over till it's over.
And now, will you please join the Wolves and the Mavericks in the singing of our national anthem?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Play ball!
Thank you.